Hi everyone, my name is José Pedro Espada. I am the chair of the organizing committee of the International Congress of Clinical and Health Psychology with Children and Adolescents. I am delighted to host this interview with Professor Jane Barlow from University of Oxford. Professor Barlow is chair in evidence-based intervention and policy evaluation in the Department of Public Health. She is president of the Association of Infant Mental Health. Her research focuses on the identification of effective methods for high-risk mothers and babies during the perinatal period. She has undertaken extensive research on the effectiveness of interventions in reducing child abuse and neglect. Recent research highlights the importance of the pre-birth period in terms of the psychological well-being of the child. Professor Barlow, what do you think are the main factors associated to the pre-birth period for the psychological well-being of the child?
Well, the recent research suggests that there are basically two key pathways. One is a physiological pathway, and the other is more of a relationship-based. And of course, these two pathways are related because, of course, we recognize that women who, for example, are experiencing domestic violence or substance dependency are much more likely to have very negative representations of the developing baby.
Mm-hmm. And there are early interventions aimed at improving health outcomes for parents and young children, particularly during pregnancy and the postnatal period. In which way are these interventions effective for their purpose?
Yes, for the better part, they are. So we typically think of these interventions in terms of whether they are primary, secondary, or tertiary prevention. So primary preventive interventions are either universal interventions, and we know that the use of health messages and texting and things of this sort can change behaviours during the perinatal period. If we think of targeted interventions, we have very nice evidence now about the effectiveness of preparation for parenting. Some home visiting programs also appear to be effective when delivered to targeted audiences during the perinatal period. If we think of secondary prevention, for example, women who are experiencing chronic anxiety or depression may well be supported by some of the new interventions that have been developed for working with women in the antenatal. And then at the tertiary level of prevention, there are a range of methods of working that are really targeted at much more high risk, such as women experiencing domestic violence or who might have a mental health problem or who are dependent on substances.
Dr. Barlow, in your opinion, what are the main current challenges for researchers and clinicians who work to improve the situation of high-risk mothers and babies during the perinatal period?
That's a very interesting question. For me, I think one of the main challenges really are protecting the unborn baby, and particularly protecting it in high-risk groups of women who may be reluctant for whatever reason to change their existing lifestyle. So women who have been heavily dependent on alcohol or substances for a long period, become pregnant as a result of their erratic lifestyle. There's very little commitment to the unborn baby. And in a sense, they see little reason to discontinue their existing lifestyle.
And if you have to indicate some lessons learned from your experience on the impact of maternal functioning in pregnancy on child development, which ones would you point out?
Some of the lessons I would say, particularly again, thinking in terms of working effectively with high-risk groups of mums and dads, I'd say that we really need to recognize importance of adapting our intervention to meet the needs of the population rather than expecting these vulnerable groups to adapt to the intervention.
Okay. Professor Barlow, you also have worked on the efficacy of interventions in the field of child protection. You are currently working to develop a new pre-birth pathway to support vulnerable pregnant women and an intervention for families in which there is domestic abuse. Could you tell us about these interventions?
Yes, absolutely. The pre-birth pathway involved us working with a small group of social workers and family support workers. We trained them in the delivery of the parents under pressure module, that's parent under pressure program, which is an individualized parenting program that can be, it has 12 modules and can be used selectively, each of the modules with to meet the parents' individual needs. So we identified very high-risk women in pregnancy, and they were referred through to the pathway for about 18 weeks, and we did some intensive assessment with them, and then we put in place this team of social workers and family support workers to work therapeutically with them during pregnancy and the early postnatal period.
Finally, you will give a keynote lecture at the upcoming conference in Seville, titled Begin Before Birth, the Impact of Maternal Functioning in Pregnancy on Child Development. Could you please give us some advances of the contents of your lecture?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, I will be talking about many of the things that we have been talking about today, essentially. So I will be drawing on the very latest research about these two different pathways in pregnancy and what we now know in terms of the way in which each of them can impact on well-being and development of the unborn baby, but then we've also got some very nice evidence regarding the longer term impact on the psychological function of the child throughout childhood and also through adolescence. I'll also be talking a little bit about some of the effective methods of working that can be used during the perinatal period to address some of the problems that can occur.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so thank you very much for your time and kindness, Professor Barlow. We are looking forward to listening to you in Seville. Thank you very much.
I'm looking forward to coming. Thank you.